We are marking, as we have heard, the ninth year of the revolution of the people of Bahrain. It is the ninth year, but it is the hundredth year, the hundredth, the centenary of ongoing revolution since 1922. So we are not only marking one uprising, we are marking the people's revolt over the decades in order to achieve fundamental change in the political system in that island. Every day in Bahrain is a difficult one. Every corner there are challenges. At every night there are raids, there are arrests, there are detentions. Every bus that takes people to their jobs is full of anger and anxiety. This is the situation in that country. Men, women, and children live their lives in fear. Why? Because simply the regime has come from outside, occupied the land, and attempted to enforce an apartheid-style regime. And this is rejected by the people who want to have their own say in how their country is run, how their wealth is distributed, how their resources are managed. None of this exists under dictatorships. It's not just a dictatorship, it is a hereditary one, whereby you have a ruler and the day he goes, his son will assume the kingship. He will become the new ruler, and so on and so forth. The people have no value, have no price, no place in running their own country. This is why people can easily be shot. If this shot did for participating in a peaceful protest, if this protest now is held in Bahrain, almost everyone in this protest would go to jail. And what is the charge? Threatening the peace or threatening the existence of the regime, plotting to overthrow the regime, and so on and so forth. This is what our people face every day there in that big jail. Big jail is the country itself, and smaller jails are where thousands of people are held in many instances in solitary confinement, in chains, in shackles, because they are the natives. The natives have no place, have no rights, but the people who come from outside, who occupy the land by force, are the people who must be given all the rights. They have every right to abuse the natives by killing, by torturing, by banishment, by removing and revoking their citizenship, or by any other humiliation and disrespect. This is why here today we are trying to tell the people of the world that the revolution of Bahrain will continue. It had started 100 years ago, and it flared up at almost every 10 years. It would see a spike in its effort and in its presence in the streets. And we are also marking the ninth year of the latest version of that revolution that started on 14th of February 2011. From now on, I do not believe that there will be a decade without major confrontation between the natives and the occupiers of the land. The occupiers are the Al Khalifa and whoever they bring from outside, whether it is the Saudi army, the Emirati army, or any other form of forces from Pakistan or from Jordan or from any other country. So the struggle will continue. I personally have witnessed many struggles. Since the 60s, we have seen struggles going on. In the 60s, in the 70s, in the 80s, in the 90s, and we are seeing it today. We saw it yesterday, last night, and we will see it tonight. We will see it tomorrow. We will see it on the 14th of February when the people remember to their victims. Just one point about how the vicious regime is trying to stop the marking of the occasion. Yesterday, the father of the first martyr of the revolution, the Ali Mushamah, who was martyred on the 14th of February 2011. His father was taken away from his family 2 days ago. No, nothing is known about him because they don't want him to be there in the street on the 14th, because he will remind the people of the fate of his son, who was taken illegitimately from him on that fateful day. And of course, anyone who is likely to have influence of the people has also been snatched and taken away from the public view. So that doesn't stop the people from revolting. It's not going to end the revolution. The revolution started only to finish, and it will only finish when there is a fundamental political change in the country. The situation is not going to allow to continue, because it has just become a disaster to everyone. So we pledge to our martyrs that we will not keep quiet, we will not keep silent about torturers, about killers, about executioners. These executioners have to face the justice inside the country or elsewhere. بما أننا نقف هنا هذا اليوم لنؤبن شهداءنا الذين سقطوا في 14 من فبراير من العام 2011، والذين سقطوا تباعا حتى بلغ عددهم أكثر من 200، فيما نقف هنا مؤبنين نستحضر كل دقيقة من هذه الثورة المظفرة التي هي امتداد لثورات متواصلة منذ 100 عام تقريبا. 100 عام من الثورات لن تتوقف، وثورة 14 فبراير الأخيرة لن تكون آخرها، وسنشهد تصاعدا متواصلا للغضب الشعبي الهادف لإسقاط هذا النظام وإبعاده عن الصورة. إنه نظام لا يستحق البقاء، لأنه جائر، ظالم، بائس، معاد للإنسانية، عدو للأخلاق والقيم، مخالف لكافة أشكال المواثيق الدولية والعهود. ولذلك نحن هنا نقول أننا ماضون على طريق هذه الثورة، أننا سائرون باتجاه التغيير، أننا لن نقبل الاستبداد يوما، لن نقر الحكم التوارثي الاستبدادي أيا كان شكله. نعم، يستطيع أن يستعين بالأجانب، يستعين بالجيش السعودي، الجيش الإماراتي، الجيوش، القوات الباكستانية، الأردنية وسواها، لكن الله سبحانه وتعالى له بالمرصاد، والشعب لن ينام على ضيم يوما، وسيظل باقيا وصامدا في الميدان حتى يحقق النصر المؤزل بعون الله تعالى، وذلك وعد إلهي غير مكذوب. وشكرا لكم على حسن استماعكم، ونحن سنكون مواصلين على خط أولئك الثوار حتى يقضي الله بيننا وبين القوم الظالمين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.